we want to keep evolving what we do and changing what we do.
I read in I'm not sure if it was a blog or an interview, that you try to create a universe around the music, also maybe with the live performances.
Yeah.
How important, what is for you, would maybe if you would create a universe in a small scale, what would be the ideal environment for the music to listen to?
I don't know. I think, personally for me, what I like in music is when I hear something that I feel like I know somehow, not that I've heard it before, but it seems familiar somehow. It kind of discovers something inside of me that I never knew was there, you know, like a surprise, something unexpected. And that's the most powerful thing. And I don't know what state of mind I need to be in. I just think it depends on the music, you know. But that's what's interesting about music to me, is that feeling, you know.
Can you describe maybe a recent moment that you had such a discovery that you got too into something in yourself?
I don't know if there's, well, I think probably listening to some of the contemporary minimalist composers like John Adams and Steve Reich, their pieces often give me that feeling, because they're no, like, it's not very set in stone what they do. It's no, well, it is actually very systematic, but it's not, you know, there'll often be twists and turns that you'd never expect, you know, and that's what I like. I think when you listen to the radio, most songs, they play for 10 seconds and then you already know the whole song, you know, because you've kind of, you know what's going to happen, you know, there's going to be a chorus and then there's going to be a bridge and then, you know, it becomes boring.
Although you made some, a big radio play actually with some of your songs.
Yeah.
Is it something that maybe you see as a big achievement that you made the radio listener listen to maybe some things that aren't that predictable?
That's definitely something that we take pride in, is trying to change what popular music could be, you know? But we're not trying to be avant-garde, you know? We're trying to make something that people can have an immediate emotional response to, but also something that keeps being interesting, you know, keeps having new layers to peel off. That's the challenge, really, for us.
Is that a thin line, to be not cross it towards the avant-garde side? Is it?
Of course, sometimes we cross too much over to the other side, and sometimes, you know, sometimes it becomes too plain, you know, and then we just skip it throughout that song.
Who is overseeing the whole process when it goes too far? Is that some yourselves or a producer?
No, it's hard. We do that ourselves, I think. Obviously, when we work with producers, they'll have opinions as well, and we all work together, but it's mostly internally in the band, I think. We just said, like, is this really, are we going to like this song in 3 years? I don't think so. We throw it out.
So it has to be a bit visionary then. Can you maybe, as far as I saw, the writing, the whole process in the creation of an album, do you start with a sort of isolation? I saw on a video that you went to southern France. How important is it to go into such an environment for you to make a first step?
Well, we try and change the method of writing a lot, you know, because if you're stuck in one place in a practice space with electric guitars and all of that, you know, that's great for some things, but sometimes it's good to change the environment a little bit. And the reason we went to the south of France is because we didn't really have a place to work in Copenhagen, and we were taking some time off between touring in America. And we needed to be somewhere that was really nice, you know, and we rented this house and there's a pool and we could just work there. And sometimes we just work out in the countryside in Denmark, and with just acoustic guitars and some percussion and piano maybe.
And at what point do you maybe take it to a next step? More, you read, you talk a lot about music, but at what point do you say, well, we have enough ingredients now to start mixing stuff?
We always want to get started in the studio before the producer does, because we kind of feel in our heads the stuff is finished, you know, we know kind of what we want to do, but it's really hard to convince other people who don't see the whole thing in their heads, you know. So oftentimes we'll have to demo for a while, you know, we'll send it to the label and we'll send it to the producer, and then finally we, you know, they agree for us to go in the studio.